Before we get started, I need to address something. In the last video, I used this image as a generic reference for MLP analysts because the usual reference image I would use, I was told not to use anymore by the artist. Now, anyone with at least a single working eyeball in their skull could tell at a glance that not everyone in this image was an analyst, an insignificant clerical error that I was aware of when I put the image in the video in the first place. But a small handful of people opted to focus on this minor clerical error to assert that I don't know who's an analyst anymore because contending with the actual meat of the video would have been too much effort. But I would just like to take this time to apologize for being so inconsiderate to such easily distracted viewers, and I will be certain not to make such glaring mistakes that completely dominate your limited attention span in the future. There's a myth I want to dispel about the way content is created, namely that something that's good takes time, and that the longer something takes, the better it will be. This simply isn't true. There is always going to be a point where long production time stops being about ensuring the best quality and starts being about poor time management or simply poor scheduling. This is especially true in the case of television cartoons, where entire seasons are produced simultaneously and often completed long before they see release. So when the subject of long and frequent hiatuses come up, the common explanation of episodes take a while to make is often a false belief because the next episode has likely already been completed months ago. I have been very vocal in my belief that content droughts are terrible. Terrible for the creator, terrible for the audience, and terrible for everyone in between. I make a point to always try and keep a reliable schedule, and I have been highly critical of my colleagues when they fall into the same trap of having long droughts of content and coming out of it with very little to show. And a television show's first concern should be ensuring that it has to take as few hiatuses as humanly possible. Yes, a hiatus between seasons is common, as the production crew needs to take those accumulated vacation days at some point, but having breaks mid-season should be avoided wherever possible. No show flagrantly disregards this idea more than Steven Universe, which has flittered back and forth between regular airings, long hiatuses broken up by Steven bombs, and an ocean of disposable episodes in between. Now, usually when I criticize Steven Universe, I find myself very alone in my belief that this is not in fact the second coming of Big Gay Lady Jesus. But as it turns out, Steven Universe's erratic scheduling has been frustrating and annoying for even the series' most die-hard fans. Unfortunately, I can't help but wonder if this tediously drawn-out schedule is the reason Steven Universe has been so heavily adored by its fans. What reason does a company like Cartoon Network have to spread out releases like this? Hype mongering. By making both adult and child fans wait exorbitant amounts of time in between new releases, those fans become starved for new content. And so even the most mundane releases become massive anticipated events. This has the twofold effect of supercharging ratings beyond what they would normally have gotten, as well as making the overall fanbase and critics significantly less critically discerning. As we've talked about before, Steven Universe has massive, glaring problems that almost get Steven universally ignored in the frothing hype of there simply being a new episode. Fans get so starved for content that it doesn't matter if that content is crap. They're just happy to have anything. And it works. Well, it worked. Looking at the ratings for each Steven bomb has shown that the first two Steven bombs saw spikes in ratings, but each subsequent Steven bomb leveled out unless it contained a special episode, with the Summer of Steven having only Bismuth, Beta, and Earthlings as massively successful as far as ratings goes. And this is because Cartoon Network has failed to learn the most important lesson about starving fans that Blizzard has had to learn the hard way. Eventually, they stop getting excited, and they start getting angry. While Steven Universe fans remain as critically undiscerning as ever, they've started getting increasingly angry and vocal about the constant repetitive hiatuses. New Steven bombs are met with less and less jubilation and more anger, and rightfully so. A Steven bomb consists of 5 episodes aired on 5 consecutive days, but for any normal show, that's 5 weeks of content just pissed away. Content that could have been spaced out a lot better and caused much less frustration and irritation. Of course the series has to go on hiatus all the time when it airs a month's worth of episodes in the span of a few days. And they do this constantly. Cartoon Network drops so many bombs that I'm pretty sure Trump is about to sign an executive order banning Disney XD from the country. If they just calmed the fuck down, these hiatuses wouldn't need to be so omnipresent. It's not a matter of episodes taking a long time to make, it's a matter of not properly spacing out the episodes that they've already made to create less overall downtime. But, I can hear you cry, why would they stop releasing episodes in bursts if it creates so much excitement and publicity? Well, first of all, thanks for broadcasting that you weren't paying attention, because I already told you why. You can see by the ratings that most of the Steven bombs have started to even out as far as the ratings go. And that's because when you're seemingly always on hiatus, people move from being angry to being bored. And then other, more professional shows come on and take their attention. Steven Universe might have had the advantage of being one of the few cartoons that goes hog wild with LGBT representation, a demographic that has been hungry for something for decades now. But eventually, other producers are gonna pull their heads out of their asses and start getting on that bandwagon. bandwagon as well. Star vs. the Forces of Evil has been making baby steps toward LGBT representation, and the theories about Marco possibly being transgender are more detailed and descriptive than any theory that's oozed its way out of Steven Universe. Cartoon Network's short-term avarice is likely going to kill one of its best shows out of boring its own audience to death. Steven Universe would benefit greatly from a consistent return to a weekly schedule for longer than a few weeks. Not just from the constant presence and attention that staying in the limelight could give it, but also from the comfort of a consistent release schedule, making fans less hype-driven and more critically discerning, so that more pressure is put on Sugar to not only tell the story she's been drip-feeding for several years now, but also to maybe stop completely fucking up their heavier subject matter. You know, that'd be swell. If there's any advice I could give to any content creators out there, it's make sure you can produce something reliably. You know, if you want to do reviews, try not to take 3 months to make a single review, because people are going to swiftly get bored of waiting. Sure, you might have those few zealots who will wait years for anything from you, but the vast majority simply won't be that patient, and a consistent release schedule keeps people's expectations at a reasonable level. Remember, people sincerely believe that if something is taking you forever to make, that means you're putting all kinds of work in it to make it amazing. Any actual content creators will know that's not how anything works. Things take longer to make for a multitude of reasons that have nothing to do with production time. We all have lives and other things to do with our time that don't involve working on videos. But when the audience so thoroughly believes that, it creates massively high expectations in people, which leads to disappointment. Hopefully, some of the people watching this have had this myth dispelled for them, but for the rest, continued procrastination is only going to hurt you in the long run. My name is Lily, and I hope you join me again in the future.